I'm really touched and humbled to receive an honorary degree today from the University of Manitoba. I want to thank you first and foremost for letting me share this special moment with you. I'm not a doctor, despite the honorary doctorate. I'll never be that talented. I'm just a lowly journalist. I tell stories, and I love telling stories. Most of them are even true. For 30 years, I've tried to help Canadians understand their health system and their medical care, inspired by the medical needs of my own parents, which were very profound and long-lasting. In that time, I've seen tremendous advances in medicine, and I've met, quite literally, thousands of health professionals, from students like yourselves to Nobel laureates. And I've met many patients, from those with rare genetic mutations to those with everyday ailments, from those cured miraculously to those who died needlessly. Today, I'd like to take a few moments to share what I've learned in telling their stories. And I'm going to be brief because I know that all you care about is coming up here and getting your name called. So, one of the greatest privileges in our society is to have the letters MD after your name, like you're going to. Those two letters confer great power, and with power comes great responsibility. Voltaire said that, and so did Spider-Man. Depends on your literary predilections, which you prefer. Shortly, you're going to all be taking the Hippocratic Oath. Now, you've probably heard that it says, first do no harm. That's not actually true. That's just bad journalism. It doesn't say those words, but it says a lot of important things. I think the line that matters most in the oath, and I've heard the oath many times over the years, I think the line that matters most is this one. Whatsoever house I may enter, my visit shall be for the convenience and advantage of the patient. Please don't forget that line. Sadly, too many physicians today fail to honor that part of the pledge. They don't put patients first. In Canada, we deliver good medical care, but we've essentially built a sickness care system rather than a health system. We've designed that system for the convenience of practitioners, not of patients. Modern medicine has become so specialized that many physicians today treat specific syndromes and body parts, and the patient herself gets lost in the process. We've filled our temples of medicine with such bedazzling high-tech tools that we've forgotten that we should treat people where they live. That's what they deserve. In our desire to cure, we overtreat. We fail too often to say the three most important words in medicine: I don't know. There's no shame in saying that. We see death as a failure instead of aspiring to make patients comfortable and at peace at the end of life. In our unrelenting quest for efficiency and measurement, we too often lose sight of what really matters. The only thing that matters, and it's the patient. Your mother, your father, somebody else's mother or father or child, that's all that matters. What do patients want? What are their goals? I hope those questions will guide your practice for your whole life. For some patients, the goal is to repair acute woes, to help them live longer. But they're a minority. Most of your patients are going to be older. They're going to have a number of chronic conditions, and they're going to be nearing the end of life, as my parents were. Their goals are very different. But nobody ever asked them their goals. They should have. They didn't want to be cured. They wanted a better quality of life for the time they had left. They wanted to be at home. They didn't want to live with the fear of falling down. They didn't want to be in pain. They didn't want to be a burden. And most of all, they didn't want to be alone. They didn't expect miracles, but they really wanted a little bit of respect. They didn't fear dying. They feared losing their autonomy and their dignity. And our health system takes that away all too often. They didn't care about metrics or age-adjusted mortality rates or fancy new genomic tests. They just wanted to be listened to and to be heard by their healthcare workers. We hear a lot these days about personalized medicine and its promise, about drugs and treatments that could be tailored to your specific genomic and epigenetic markers. But you know what people really long for? They long for personal medicine, not personalized medicine. They crave human connection. Not just care, but caring. And there's a difference. The very best medicine you can offer your patients is a listening ear. The very best treatment you can offer them is a compassionate heart. Now, some of you, the more cynical among you, will say, ah, this is all just feel-good, Deepak Chopra-like nonsense. What does he know? But I don't think that's true. I think the more sophisticated and complex medicine becomes, the more the basics really matter. What did you learn in your years in medical school? You learned anatomy, biochemistry, genomics, countless mnemonics to help you remember bits of knowledge. You know how to deliver babies, treat cancer, diabetes, depression, asthma, take out people's appendix, do MRIs, PCIs, all kinds of things, all kinds of procedures. I think what you're going to learn now in the real world is that physical woes are the least of people's worries. Their health problems aren't strictly caused by mutating cells, opportunistic pathogens, and poor genes, but by poverty, lack of education, poor housing, social isolation, the trauma of residential schools, and so on. I think you're going to learn sooner or later humility. It's an important trait. The earlier you learn it, the better the doctor you're going to be. In this, the internet age, we're drowning in information, but we're starving for wisdom, and no one more so than patients who are scared. I urge you, as you forge long and successful and prosperous careers, to not just be smart, but to be wise. In every interaction you have, embrace the ancient wisdom of Hippocrates. Whatsoever house I may enter, my visit shall be for the convenience and the advantage of the patient. Thank you.